Now let's cover shock emergencies. In this scenario, we had an individual who was bleeding from an arterial wound and lost quite a bit of blood. Now, they didn't pass out, but they were starting to feel dizzy and lightheaded. So we helped lay them to the ground, and now we're going to be suspect that they either are going into kind of a psychogenic psychosomatic shock, which is more psychological because they've seen all the blood and they're concerned, or they might have lost enough that they're having some hypovolemic shock, which means low blood volume. Either way, the symptoms are the same, and we're not going to take a chance. We're going to treat them. Gloves are on, our shield is available with a one-way valve, and we've checked for scene safety. The scene is safe. They are responding to me, they are breathing normally, and they do have a pulse. So it's still something where we're trying to decide, do we call 911 or not? But as soon as I see that they're pale, that they're starting to lose a level of consciousness or going to pass out, in my opinion, that's time to call 911. You in the plaid shirt, go call 911 and come back. Bring an AED with you if you can find one. And so now we're ready to begin treatment. I want to reassess like I just did for normal breathing and for a pulse, but now I see that they're a little pale. I squeeze the nail bed and turn it white, and then I let go. It takes longer than it takes me to say capillary refill for it to refill. This is an early sign of potential shock. To treat this, I'm now going to explain to my patient what's going on. I'm going to elevate their legs. It's important that you just find something that's 6-12 inches high. It doesn't have to be super high, but you could use a stool, a chair, a box, whatever you have available. Now, I have a blanket here, but you wouldn't have to necessarily use a blanket. You could use coats, you could use newspaper, anything that helps maintain the body temperature of the person that is going into shock, because this is going to help maintain their core body temperature. When they start going into shock, their body shunts the blood from the extremities and brings it back to their vital organs. This makes them very cold to the peripheral. When this happens, the body will only take so long before it thinks it needs to reheat the rest of the body. When it does that, it will re-vasodilate, and the blood pressure that they do have could drop again. So we want to help combat that by keeping them warm, comforting them, and watching for regular breathing, making sure they're awake, and if they ever change, lose their breathing, lose their pulse, we're going to respond with CPR and wait for EMS to arrive.